today are about what's happening in Myanmar today. And I was hoping in Parliament 2 weeks ago to support a motion which I brought for the Parliament along with my colleague Maureen Van Bakkenen to call on the Australian government to do more. But as you may remember, Malcolm Turnbull cancelled Parliament and denied us the opportunity to prosecute that issue and many other issues. It was a shameful act, one of many shameful acts by this Prime Minister. And next year, Australia will be on the Human Rights Council. It presents us, it's something to laugh about at so many
levels. It's Labor Party.
But it also provides us with
a great
yeah.
opportunity
to You can heckle him if you want.
The opportunity we have to speak out the
Human Rights Council. So what's Labor doing? Yeah, it's a shame, Labor, shame.
Do you want to stay?
Yeah, I can do
you
this.
You don't have to.
It's okay, yeah, I can do it.
You don't have to.
That's up to you.
When we don't apply those standards ourselves. And this year, like last year, like the year before that, yeah, you'll get a chance, mate. You'll get a chance. Plenty of people. I'm happy to have a conversation about anything you like in 2 minutes when I finish my contribution, okay? So all I want to do is to say a couple of things about my contribution to fighting for human rights as a lawyer, as an activist and a member of the Labor Party. And if people want to shout me down, perhaps they can do that off stage in 2 minutes' time, mate, in 2 minutes. Let me say this. I am committed to doing all I can to stand up for the rights of asylum seekers. And mate, I don't remember seeing you in the High Court in 2001 when I was there. I don't remember seeing you there, okay? What I want to say is this. I heard Aziz a minute ago, or 5 minutes ago, I heard his sense of courage and his sense of hope. And I think people can say what they want to me, but the message that we must send back to him and his 600 friends and comrades is that we hear them and we are prepared to fight for them, okay? Can we send that message back to him? And can I say to the Rohingya in Cox's Bazaar, elsewhere, and also other persecuted minorities in Myanmar like the Karen, one thing Australia has to do and all Australians must do is to deny this sense that you can have a democracy built on the denial of existence of a people. That is what is fundamentally at stake in what's going on in Myanmar. And that is why it's so important that we attend to doing the right thing at home so we can be an exemplar abroad. And lastly, I think we do need to bear witness to Aziz. And I hope and expect that people here will hold me to account for my actions. In the Parliament, in the community, and in the Labor Party. You will hold me to account, but let us all work together to give voice to these people's experiences, to recognise that there may be difficult challenges when it comes to how we get the policy balance right.
Bring them here!
But there's one really easy question.
Say bring them here!
Really easy question.
Say bring them here!
Allow people who have asked for our help to be tortured. Should we do that? Should we stand in their way? Or should we keep them safe and secure? I have been a consistent advocate for that and I'll continue to be. Let's show our support for these men today.
Bring them here!
Bring them here!
Thank you. We do need